GDN is an international public institution, organization, and the mission is to build research capacity in all developing countries. And as part of this mission, we have been focusing a lot on the African continent. We have regional partners in the whole world, and in Africa, one of our main partners is the African Economic Research Consortium, which is based in Nairobi. And we do with them a number of programs. We help them finance through research competitions the work of young researchers every year. And we are now engaged in a more structural program on a number of aspects, including aid effectiveness, the role of new donors in Africa, agricultural development, and a number of issues. Beyond that, GDN has been working on structural transformation, and as you know, agriculture is part of the structural transformation process. We held a major conference like the one that we have been organizing with OCPPC here in Casablanca. Last year it was in Ghana on the theme of structural transformation, and that already involved a lot of African researchers working on structural transformation and the role of agriculture. So this conference is a follow-up basically on that whole set of initiatives. And we started recently a project on natural resource management, which is not exactly on agriculture, but it's linked, of course, to all these debates about sustainable agricultural development. And that focuses on three countries, Mauritius, Madagascar, and Morocco. So that's some examples of what we do, but basically all of our programs are open to African researchers. And on top of that, we have right now some specific initiatives concentrating on Africa. I think it's a difficult question, because it's always easy in seminars and conferences everywhere to say this is what we should do and this is what we need to do, and nobody knows exactly who is the we who should do things. So my point is that we need to know more, we need to have more knowledge of the local situations, because the actions will come from the people themselves, locally, from the people, from the governments. So what is needed for the Green Revolution is an understanding of the major issues right now, and that requires more knowledge locally about the way in which farmers take their decisions, the obstacles that they face. And in Africa, we know some of these obstacles, especially with infrastructure development, storage facilities, access to credit, sometimes the lack of access to innovation. So all these questions are part of the debate about the new revolution, the new green revolution in Africa and elsewhere. So what matters is a better understanding of the local context, a better understanding by the government that they need to focus in priority on agriculture, and of course a good understanding about the environmental constraints that face that farmers are facing in Africa nowadays, and especially on the African continent, the degradation of soils, of land, has become a very important issue. I think it is flowing. It is flowing under the form of knowledge and recommendations. But the problem is that this knowledge is global and needs to be contextualized to be able to inform local policies. So the channel that is missing is a connection between global knowledge and local academic work. And that's why at GDN we focus a lot in building the capacity of local researchers, because I think they are vital in producing good local knowledge and also in using the global knowledge and adapting it to the needs of informing local policies. It's part of the ownership issue as well. I think you need the local knowledge for policymakers to be willing to listen to academics and the recommendations that come from foreign work.